Document templates. With Rentman, you can customize the layout of all your documents with document templates. Here you see an example of a custom-made document template. You will find the document template editor under Configuration. Under Document Templates, you will find all templates that are added to your library, sorted by type. These can be system templates or custom templates. System templates are updated by Rentman and cannot be edited, except for the font and color. You can add, edit, duplicate and delete templates. Rentman offers useful and ready-to-use templates for each document type. If you are looking for a system template, which is not in your library, you add it from the template library. Here you will find a list of templates in different languages. We are going to customize a quotation template. We start with a system template, and to edit it, we need to duplicate it. Now the template can be edited. We recommend to always duplicate a template before making any changes to make sure you don't lose templates. The shown slip is based on a real example slip generated in our database. If nothing is shown here, make sure to generate a slip in a project first. If you have a good recent example slip, you can select it from the drop-down menu. Note, you have to create a slip of the same type to have an example. Just having a project without a slip will not show an example. In the widget, we find the template settings. To recognize our new template, we give the new name. The type gives the type of the template and with that the information shown in the document. You can hide certain templates from your lists by setting hidden to yes. Every document is built with modules. Text modules are based on text, tables and variables and are flexible to use. And preset modules with columns and settings used for more complicated information like planned equipment or a sum module. We can reorder modules by dragging and dropping the placement icon and remove a module by clicking the trash icon. We removed our equipment module but really do need it. So we add the module by simply dragging it from the widget and dropping it into the place we wanted in the document. We want our project information aligned to the right and show the project name above the project number. To do this, we add a section of two columns which gives an adjustable divider. We drag the text module with the project information to the right side of the section and make it a little wider. Next, we click the pencil icon on the text module and add a row above the project number. This gives an extra row of two columns. In the left column, we type project name. In the right column, we want to show the actual project name. We do this with a variable. Place the cursor where you want to put the variable. In the widget, click on the variable dropdown. The project name is related to the quotation, so we select quotation. If there are arrows after a variable, it means that there is a deep layer. Select project and then select name. You can see there are a lot of variables which can be used in your documents. Click the plus to add the variable in your document at the place of the cursor. We want to make sure the equipment module always starts on a new page. We can do this by adding the page break module. Let's edit a preset module. In this case, we are going to show the total amount and discount of the equipment module. You can edit modules by clicking the pencil icon. Here you will find a list of all sorts of display options which differ per module. By clicking Show Advanced Settings, you will get extra options. These will vary per module. To show the total amount and discount, we will scroll to the bottom. Here we find the options to display total sum of all equipment and show discount in total sum. Let's add the column to show the equipment type. You can customize the columns by clicking Columns. We choose the variable Equipment Planning, Equipment, Type and click the plus. We want to show the type before the name. To rearrange the columns, we drag the placement icon. By clicking on the Just Edit column, we can edit the width, margins, header text and alignment. If you leave the margin blank, it will fill up the rest. And to remove a column, click the Remove icon. Let's change the style and margins of our template. we want to edit the margin of the equipment module, give the text of the content of kits a lighter color, and delete the border around the header. Style and margin editing is done in a what you see is what you get kind of way. Click something and you can change how it looks. The settings displayed here are only relevant for the selected part of the template. Select the module and scroll down in the widget to find the relevant settings. We want the equipment module to be a bit smaller and given a round border. We select the equipment module and enter a left and right margin and select rounded border. We want the module names to match our letterhead. Select a module name and give in a text color. Set the top line to none, the bottom line to closed, and color the bottom line. To match the headers with the letterhead, we select the header, set the top line to none, the bottom line to closed, and color the bottom line. Set the text color. Now we want to remove the sidebars of the headers. Click on the right side of the header, set the right line to none. And do the same for the left side of the header, and now the left line. Now all our headers will match our letterhead. To make equipment and function groups more clear, we select the names of the groups and give them a color. We want to make it more clear what the contents of a kit are, so we select the contents, set the style to italic, and give it a lighter gray color. We want our summation lines to also match our letterhead. Therefore, select the line and give it a text color. By selecting all text, we can choose a different font for the complete layout. Our digital signing button should be green. Select the digital signing button and change the color. When you are done styling, you click Save and the document will be in your library. The letterhead can be seen as the background image of your documents. You can use it to personalize your documents with your company logo, company information and visual design. Letterheads are found on a configuration, letterhead. Here you can upload your letterhead in PDF format. Choose a standard size and set the margins. If you have a logo of 4 cm, you need to set the top margin to 4 cm to make sure they don't overlap. Your letterhead can also consist of multiple pages. If this is the case, the first page of your letterhead will be used for the first page of your documents. The second page of your letterhead will be used for the second page of your document, and so on. If your document has more pages than your letterhead, the last page of your letterhead will be used for the rest of the document. If you want to leave the first page blank, you check the box. Page numbers can be added by clicking this checkbox. On the bottom, you can select where the letterhead can be used. For instance, we don't want our quotation letterhead to show up when we create a packing slip. Make it easy for yourself and your crew members to select the correct document templates and letterhead for different slips. For dry hire projects, you might want to use the extended quotation template by default. But for productions, you might want to have a simpler quotation showing the prices only by equipment group. You can set the default letterhead and templates in the Project Type tab in the Configuration. You can set a default template for quotation, contract and invoice, and set a letterhead. When you create a new project with this project type, it will select these templates and letterheads by default. Templates you do not use should never be an option to choose. They can only confuse you and your crew members. You can do this by opening a document template you want to hide, and put hidden to yes to hide the template from the drop-down list. Do this for all templates you will not use. We are now going to create a quote. In the project under the financial tab, click print slip, create quotation. Here the system template is set as default with no letterhead. We select our newly created document template and our letterhead and click regenerate. Our changes look exactly how we want it. If this would not be the case, we can easily go back and make more changes. We will shortly show a few use cases that are frequently asked. We use the packing slip template for these examples. Showing clearly what equipment comes from sub-hire is important to show on the packing slip. There are multiple ways to do this. We will show the two most used options. First way is to add a column for the total number of equipment that should come from sub-hire jobs. For this, we add the column number of sub-hire jobs. The second way is to add the module sub-hire equipment on your packing slip. This will show all sub-hired equipment and their suppliers connected to this project in a separate module. The module linked with sub-hire will show which sub-hire projects are linked with this project, but not the equipment lines. We have added a warehouse location to each equipment item and want to make it easier for our warehouse guys to find the equipment on the packing slip. We want to group our equipment on the warehouse location and show their location. Go to the equipment module and click the pencil icon. Under Group By, we select Location in Warehouse. There is an option for custom text when creating slips. These are all shown with a variable and are present in system templates in a text module with the variable. If you don't have it in your template, you can add the variable slip, text, or check in the system template how this is set up there. When working with subprojects, you can separate modules per subproject. We want to show the equipment module separately for each subproject with the name of the subproject above. We can do this by adding the subproject module. The subproject module will repeat itself for every subproject. If you want to use this, we recommend starting with a system template that already has the subproject module. After adding the subproject module, we drag and drop the modules in there we want to have repeated for each subproject. We will add a text module and add the variable for subproject name to make it clear what subproject the equipment belongs to. You can add extra input fields to a lot of different types of items in Rentman. We have added an extra input field to a project for lunch included, yes or no. We would like to show if lunch is included on the documents, so we will add this to our template. First, we will add the text in the text module, lunch included. Next, we will find the extra input field variable to show the yes or no selected in the project. Note that if you connect a custom field to a subproject, you first have to add the subproject divider to find the variables for the subproject.